The temporary road's coming along pretty good. I got that bladed off with the dozer and he's spreading the stone out around here. You can see I kind of got it crowned up where it is the highest point. And down here, put in a pipe this morning to take the water under the road from the ditch that I cut along the wood line. He's getting this built up a little bit. It's pretty wet and soft in there. So the water will run down that and then go under the road and out right here. You kind of see where it's flowing out at the moment. And then run on down the meadow strip there. So I'm going to start burning this morning, and this is what's left of the old trailer, I think. So it's got a bunch of nails and the old wood, so I'm going to take it down there to that lower side where the original fire was started, and then I'm going to start a new fire because there's a hole dug right there. That way all the nails and everything will be in the ground, and this should get that going real good, and I can throw some brush in that, get that burning. Then all I got to do is grab a big grapple full and it'll make getting the new fire started a lot easier. So I'm going to take this on down there, get it burning, and then I'm going to start a new fire up there by the where all the brush and everything is, so I don't have to move it so far. Get this old trailer frame pulled out. Be a mess to clean up. It was kind of old. the other fire pile going. Must be a stump in there. Then I'll get the other fire going. Once this gets burning, I can just grab a grapple full of this hot burning wood and chunk it in the pile. That usually gets it going pretty good. So that nice dry old wood caught on fire pretty good. So I'm going to come down here and push it back a little bit. I got one more load I'm going to dump out. And then I'm going to just get a big grapple full of that. That's burning nicely. Walk up here and put it in that fire pile. Get that going, and then pretty much I have all the debris right there that I can just easily lay on there. And don't have to worry about trying to track it all the way down here. Efficiency at its best.
All right, let's get a fire going. Well, we already got this one going. Let's get a good fire going. I'm gonna grab some of these hot coals here. Skidoodle back up here before it melts all the packing out of my thumb cylinder. small stuff and larger stuff so that it can burn that down while burning the stumps up.
Loads of ash and just push down here, it doesn't look like it, but that pile is actually burning pretty good in the center. I just really put a lot of stuff on it. So I got that fire started right here beside the stump. So all I gotta do is just grab them, lay them on there. And it's also right here beside the brush, so I don't have to really move that too much farther. I can sit right here and pretty much grab majority of this and lay it on here. And then we'll leave that fire down there at the bottom of the hill just to kind of burn out. So I'll get all this burnt up, probably put on the fire today. I'm calling for rain tomorrow, so I'll probably take the truck down there. There's a pile down there. Get that loaded up and brought up here while it's drier than it will be after it rains for the next 3 days. So I'm gonna go get the dozer and put the rake on it and push that material over there, all that brush and debris over there, over here. That way I can grab it, let this catch up, and I'll lay it on here, go get some lunch, come back, stack it on up some more. Well, I think I got my money's worth on that load. Figured I could get it all in one load. It's only 12 feet higher than the sides. Only got to go to right there. I think it'll work. Slow and steady wins the race. It's full. And all the trailer's cleaned up. The neighbor wants the metal, so I'm hauling it up there to him. Here we go. So we're getting a decent little road to put through here. Still a little soft spot right here. And the neighbor is up here. Looks like he's got an old Cat 955 track loader. He is out stirring around on it. So I'm gonna go up here and see where he wants me to put this stuff. She's a beaut. Looked like it had been sitting for quite a while. He's got her fired up. That's about as fast as she goes. Alrighty. I don't even think he knows I'm behind him. I'll go see where he wants me to dump this out. He's still driving around. I'm dumping the metal out in his yard here. That's where he wanted it. So that's where it's gonna be. There we go. Pile of scrap. Stuff's burning really good for me today, so I'm going to go ahead and get all this pushed up and thrown on there and let it burn down for the rain gets here tonight. Kind of grabbed everything I could get without having to track, so I'm gonna take the dozer and push it a little bit closer and stack it up on there. I'll get the drone up in the air when I stack all this on there, because I believe it's really gonna be burning then. We'll be right back.
So I've been thoroughly pleased with the burning today. That stuff back here, it has really burned great. All that stuff I had that was piled up that Timmy cleared while I was up there running that long reach. It burned up well, as you can tell, it's really hot right there. So I'm going to, I pretty much got everything stacked on here, and the best thing is to just keep it hot. So that's why I'm piling everything on here. It'll just sit here and just keep drying everything out. It's supposed to rain, that way Tim can come here tomorrow and just easily keep everything pushed up and not have to worry about getting a big pile or wet stumps burning. Probably about a dump truck load of stuff left. Burn that up tomorrow.